Hello there. These lessons come as part of my software called the Flash Human Anatomy. If you want to purchase my software, please go to my website flashhumananatomy.com. With my software, you get all my lessons, my very own illustrations, and my 3D models. Before you go to my website, please leave a positive comment or just a like. I put a link to my website in the description of this video. In this lesson, I will talk about the atlas. In human anatomy, atlas, or C1, is the most superior cervical vertebra of the spine. It is named atlas of Greek mythology. It is named that way because it supports the globe of the head. The atlas is the topmost vertebra, and along with the axis, right below it, it forms the joint connecting the head and the spine. They are also specialized to allow greater range of motion than the normal vertebra. They are also responsible for nodding and rotation movements of the head. Now I have removed the rest of the skull so we can see this vertebra better. There is an anterior arch here and a posterior arch here. The anterior arch forms about one-fifth of the ring. Its anterior surface is convex, posteriorly it's concave, and on the posterior side it's marked by a smooth circular facet called the fovea dentis. It should be right here, and it serves for the articulation with the odontoid process, or the dens, of the axis. That's this process here. As you can see, between this surface here on the anterior arch of the vertebra of the atlas and the odontoid process here, there is space. They are not touching each other, which is wrong. This model is not very detailed. They should be articulating, and the place on the anterior arch that articulates with this odontoid process should be called the fovea dentis. Fovea dentis and dentis because this process is also called sometimes the dens. We have the lateral masses here and here. The lateral masses are the most bulky and solid parts of the atlas in order to support the weight of the head. Each lateral mass carries two articular facets, superior and inferior one. Here is the superior one, and here is the inferior one, right here. As you can see, there is the same thing on the other side. The superior one is articulating with the head, and the inferior ones articulate with axis. This here is called the transfer process. The same thing on the other side. They project laterally and downward from the lateral masses, which these are the lateral masses here and here. And they serve for the attachment of the muscles which assist in rotating the head. To learn about muscles, please check out that part of my software that talks about muscles. They are long, and their anterior and posterior tubercles are fused here into one mass. And because they are fused here into one mass, they create this foramen here. This foramen is called the foramen transversarium. A break in the first vertebra is referred to as a Jefferson fracture. The pharyngeal inflammation may cause the decalcification of the atlas vertebra. This may lead to loosening of the attachment of the transverse ligament, which may eventually yield. This allows the dents of the axis to move and exert pressure on the spinal cord, causing the sudden death. Those are the two most common injuries that occurred with the atlas. These lessons come as part of my software called the Flash Human Anatomy. If you want to purchase my software, please go to my website flashhumananatomy.com. With my software, you get all my lessons, my very own illustrations, and my 3D models. Before you go to my website, please leave a positive comment or just a like. I put a link to my website in the description of this video.